The governor's Navy past resurfaced in the last few days after an article in the San Diego Reader accused Ventura of pretending to be a SEAL. The legendary elite Navy frogmen, whose name stands for Sea Air Land Teams. The article cites evidence that Ventura was in the Underwater Demolition Teams, the UDTs, a separate group that saw less combat and took fewer casualties. Ventura's spokesman, John Woodley, confirms Ventura was in the UDTs, and he says the governor has never tried to convince people otherwise.
If you travel with the governor and spend any amount of time with him, he is, you know, very forthcoming and accurate in terms of his relationship with the United States Navy. He talks about the fact that he was an underwater demolition team. In fact, he has corrected me in the past.
Ventura's speeches and interviews reveal a man who rarely says point blank, "I was a SEAL." Instead, he refers to his basic underwater demolition and SEALs training.
I can always look back to my Navy SEAL training when the going gets tough.
Or he talks about certain idiosyncrasies common to both SEALs and UDTs.
Hooyah.
Yeah.
That's a greeting. That's a greeting, an inner circle greeting of all Navy frogmen and Navy SEALs in the Special Forces Navy community.
He also lets other people call him a SEAL without correcting them.
You had been a Navy SEAL before becoming a wrestler. What's the difference between the kind of body a Navy SEAL is supposed to have and the kind of body a wrestler is supposed to have?
Oh, much, much different. I view it this way. When I was a wrestler, I could pick up buildings. When I was a Navy SEAL, I could scale them.
Still, at other times, Ventura seems to tiptoe around the distinction. The chapter in his autobiography entitled Navy SEALs emphasizes the rigors of SEAL training, which UDTs shared, and it implies he was a SEAL by describing proud SEAL traditions, such as not wearing underwear. But he does not unambiguously claim to have been one of the SEAL elite. Even the vanity license plate on Ventura's Porsche hedges the issue. It reads, UDT SEAL. Spokesman John Woodley says it's acceptable for Ventura to use SEAL as shorthand for what he was, especially since the UDTs and the SEALs merged in 1983, after Ventura left the service. The Vietnam SEAL veteran who wrote the San Diego Reader article says the distinction does matter. Bill Salisbury says SEALs took bigger risks and experienced worse casualties than the UDTs.
We know what it's like to be in Vietnam as a SEAL. We know the terror that you have to face day in and day out. And for somebody that spent most of his time floating around on a ship in the South China Sea to call himself a SEAL, we don't take that very well.
Ventura has not talked publicly about what kind of combat, if any, he saw in Vietnam. His standard line is that he's sworn to secrecy, a position Woodley echoes.
Specific duties and responsibilities that he had while he was in Southeast Asia are something that are classified in nature and that they're not to be talked about.
There's so many books written by SEALs. If that were the truth, that's just so bogus.
Jim Holman, also a Vietnam combat veteran, is the editor of the San Diego Reader.
Look up SEALs and Bibliofinder, Amazon. You'll see tons of books written about, you know, SEALs telling all those secrets.
Holman says the Salisbury article has whipped up an emotional reaction in San Diego, a Navy town with many current and former Special Forces members. He says some have written angry attacks on the reporter for criticizing Ventura, but others share his feeling that Ventura has appropriated a mystique that doesn't belong to him.
He understands the distinction, and he understands the difference it makes in politics, and he's had plenty of chance, you see, to sort of make the precise distinction in his book and in a Playboy interview. He's had a long time to talk about it, and he's had these chances to write about it.
Besides angry letters to the editor in San Diego, the question of Ventura's military record is beginning to add to the already tumultuous atmosphere inside the National Reform Party. Internet news groups are buzzing with it, and Donna Donovan, the press secretary for the anti-Ventura national leadership, called the Reader last week to get more information on the article. Salisbury says he has not been a political tool, but he does predict the Perot faction will take notice.
Ross Perot is a graduate of the Naval Academy, and he has a very, whatever else you might think of him, he has a very strong sense of honor and integrity, and I'm sure he's just, the smoke's coming out of his ears about this thing with Ventura claiming to be a SEAL.
If this issue turns into another weapon in the Reform Party's intramural struggles, Ventura may well end up regretting one of the closing lines of the SEALs chapter of his book. It reads, "We're a proud organization. If anyone tries to pretend they're a SEAL, God help them." At the Capitol, I'm Martin Kaste, Minnesota Public Radio.